Hi, I'm Alexa Simon-Mira, assistant professor at Ohio State University, reporting now for ACR 2020, and I am here with Dr. Caitlin Quinn, and I'm going to let her introduce her amazing self, and we're going to talk a little bit about large vessel vasculitis and the new imaging techniques that we're going through. So Caitlin, if you'd like to introduce yourself.
Yes, thank you for having me. I'm Caitlin Quinn. I'm a staff clinician at the National Institutes of Health, and I mainly work in the vasculitis translational research program there.
So tell me a little bit about the new work that's been in multiple abstracts about imaging for large vessel vasculitis.
So most of the work looking at FDG PET and large vessel vasculitis has been at time of diagnosis. So for the past several years, we've been doing PET scans in a research setting at NIH to monitor disease activity over time and to really try to better understand how PET changes in response to different treatments and can PET predict who may relapse and can PET predict who may go on to have angiographic progression of disease over time on MRA or CTA.
So this is really important because it's really hard to one, diagnose, and there's a huge delay in diagnosis, which has a lot of morbidity for patients. And then two, as rheumatologists, how do you change, you know, DMARD, steroids for patients in flare? And so this could be a really profound change to the way that rheumatologists practice.
Yeah, so one of the abstracts that we presented at this meeting was specifically looking at change in PET over time in response to tocilizumab treatment. The two recent randomized control trials looking at tocilizumab treatment and giant cell arteritis really focused on clinical improvement and laboratory improvement, but imaging was not systematically studied as an outcome measure. So to try to better understand how PET scans change in response to tocilizumab, we had patients who had a PET scan prior to tocilizumab treatment and then at 6-month intervals while on tocilizumab. And we saw that there was continued improvement over a 2-year treatment period with a similar amount of improvement in both the first and second years of treatment.
So it's really cool. So do you think that PET seems to have, is it better like inter-rater variability compared to like ultrasound and MRIs and all these different things? Because it's more of a standardized color change kind of view. Not that I'm a nuclear medicine doctor by any means, and not trying to minimize that.
Yeah, I think it depends on the institution and what imaging modalities people are most familiar with. But the nice thing about PET is you can really, on a scale, detect incremental change over time that sometimes can be harder to do on ultrasound, where it's very operator dependent, and even on MRA, where it's hard to gauge the amount of change in wall thickness or edema over time. So the nice thing about PET is we can really scale and measure improvement over time, which makes it a nice option as an outcome measure looking at response to treatment.
Well, I think that's super cool. I was like, before we kind of close up today in this short, quick little interview, is there anything else, any other shout outs you want to give or anything else before we kind of close out? Because I think this could really, as you are, as a practicing rheumatologist, I think that this could make a big difference for patients in how we monitor this and disease morbidity and damage if we actually had really accurate ways to follow these patients. So I'm really excited as a vasculitis doctor to be able to use these things. So,
yeah, I think my mentor is Peter Grayson at the NIH, and it's been really great to get to work with him and all of our patients that we've learned so much from and been following.
Well, awesome. Well, thank you so much for your time and so amazing work, Caitlin. As you know, you're the fellow for the VCRC, right? Like, and doing all this amazing stuff, and the ACR fellow for the vasculitis guidelines. And so I'm really excited for all these things, and I'll make you do some more interviews with us.
Thank you so much for having me.